What's poppin'? It's your boy Joey back with some more Batman Arkham Asylum. In the last episode, we made our way into the intensive treatment because we had to find our way into Killer Crocs Lair to find the plant spores that Ivy spoke about. And along the way, we ran into Scarecrow for our last time. But right now, he has a bag of hallucinogenics and he's gonna flood the sewers with it, I think. I don't really remember what he was saying about it. But right now, there is actually... Oh, crap. I'm not going to die or anything here. I just, what I wanted to do was... There's a couple Riddler trophies in this elevator shaft that I want. Oh. Actually, there's a lot of elevators. A lot of Riddler trophies around. I mean, not in the shaft, but... in the entire intensive treatment that I'm able to get now, since I have certain gadgets that I didn't have earlier on. First one is here. Just grab your back claw, tear off the vent, and Bob's your uncle. Just pop over. And you want to make sure you calculate that jump very correctly, because if you mess up, you'll fall all the way back down and have to climb back up and do it again. Excuse me. I think next one is here. Just gotta kick it open. Alright, and it's through this wall here. There's two of them, but you only need to explode the one. That's not what I wanted. There we go. Just blow it up. Blew him up! And just scan the Amadeus Arkham. Oh my god. It's not obscured, you piece of crap.
I had a sudden pang of conscience. I sought counsel from my priest on the choices I had made. I asked him if it was a sin to kill in order to save a life. The holy man said all life was sacred. But a judgment would not be upon my soul if I acted to save another. I left the confessional with my soul uplifted, convinced more than ever I am doing a service not only to mankind, but to God as well.
Religious man, doing his job for God. I already scanned this one back in the beginning of the game. That was actually the first one that we first scanned, actually. Excuse me. But those are the Riddler trophies in the shaft. I need to jump back down. And there's a riddle through here. Just gotta go through the vent. And find this little hidey hole.
What? You found 75% of my challenges?
Yes.
Right.
Now, this is like Scarecrow's little den that he created with blueprints. And look, you got the picture there. And all this stuff. Basically planning out our little trip earlier. Oh, look, mushrooms. Eat them, Batman. Just get a little mushroom high going. But there's still more trophies that I want to get. And it shouldn't really take too long. I'd say maybe 10 minutes tops, because I know where basically all of them are. It's just a matter of getting to them. I think we'll start here.
I am Edward Nigma, the world's greatest detective.
Stop stealing my nicknames, Riddler. So what you want to do is just find your way here and scan this riddle. It's Riddler's cell. You just want to hack into that box up there and go to the next destination. Oh, come on. Nice. The next trophy is actually around here. This is where Zaz was at the beginning of the game when we first started. The first trophy is up here in this vent. Just pull out your back claw, yank it down, and grapple up.
Are you up to the challenge?
I am up to the challenge. In fact, I'm doing the challenge right now. The next riddle is just over here. If I could... There you go. Just explode the wall here. And scan this cell right here. And this is another side villain named Maxi Zeus. He is a gang leader who tricks people into believing that he's like the actual descendant of Zeus, and he's a person who owns like a cult, and he tries to like trick people into thinking him he's Zeus, as I just said. So pause the video, read all about him, and we're gonna continue our way to find some more trophies. In fact, I actually think I'm almost done finding these trophies. Well, at least in here. Then we can get back to the story. Just zip down here. Holy shit! I missed a teeth. How did I miss you? That's crazy. I usually never miss them. The next trophy is right here. He's got a crack into here. I can just... Come on. There we go. And inside we have a Harley Quinn tape.
What you wanted? You did? I mean, good. How did you smuggle it in? Actually, I don't want to know. So are you ready to stop that evil murdering bat once and for all?
Of course I am. He needs to pay for what he's done to you.
Give it here, quickly.
Come on, Buck. We've got ourselves a bat to kill.
Stop outputting. Say hello to your new and improved Harley Quinn.
And they've been happily together ever since. It's such a beautiful story, you know? Like, it's so romantic. But in here is just a Amadeus Arkham, so scan for that. Find out more about him.
As he brought in the woman. Her skin, now a venomous green. The wanton creature no longer looked like a human being. Much less a woman. The Bible says, suffer not a witch to live. Yet he has once again delivered this female atrocity to our care. Once I have dealt with the monster, I think it will be time to see if green wood does, in fact, burn.
And that's the story of how Poison Ivy got to the island. Because earlier, he was talking about Killer Croc coming to the island, now it's Poison Ivy. But they're not seeing a ghost, obviously, so who is it? Once again, if you know who it is, don't spoil it for others who don't know. I think there's one last riddle. Right over here, and scan that little sign there for penguin riddle. Basically just like a little poster saying that he has his nightclub set up. And now we can continue on with the story. Hang on. I'm just making sure. What is that? I can't remember what that is. I know what that is. What the? Oh! I know what that is. Okay. Yep. I remember what it is. But right now, just need to go up these stairs, turn around the corner, and fight these yahoos. It's the bat! No, it's not Batman, it's Superman. I already made that joke. Damn, just punch us straight in the ass. Want to do is just hack into here. And now we can get through. Oh, I see a guy out of the corner there. Oh, it didn't blow up. Oh, crap, they're grabbing guns. No guns. I said no guns. Well, I just tore their asses apart. Now what you want to do here is just grab that secrets map. And here is some pictures of Killer Croc and the research everyone's been doing on him. But I got an upgrade and I want more health. That's actually going to help us later on. I see another shiny tape.
Sam, shut up! You think I'm scared of you, Cash? I've got your scent. You're
clever! And I've got yours, too. Know what? It stinks! Carry on, dog.
Please, don't do that again, Mr. Cash. It's not helping. I'm sorry about that. What can we do if you insist on hospitalizing three dogs?
Strap on whatever you like, Doc. This thing just tickles. I'm happy to wait here. Wait for the bat. He'll be back, and I'll kill him. Then Cash. Then you.
In your dream. Not you.
I'm pretty sure that's the story of how Cash lost his hand to Killer Croc. So, we know what happened. We just need to know how. And look where we are. Croc's Lair. But Ivy's plants we got here too.
One step closer, and this goes into the water. The cave will fill with your deepest, darkest nightmares, and you will never reach your precious venom roots.
Don't do it, Crane.
Well, thanks for that, Croc. Now we don't have to deal with Scarecrow ever again. Well, at least until Arkham Knight. But we have this game, and Arkham City, and probably some other games that I'll play along the way before I reach that. But right now, it's time for the Killer Croc fight. Well, it's not exactly a fight. It's kind of like us... Oh, God, never mind, I don't want to fight him. No, we have no choice. But it's kind of like you're just searching for the plants while avoiding Croc. It's not that hard. It's just
I'm heading into Croc's lair
puts you on edge.
Spores Ivy spoke about. He's in some kind of old sewer network. Send me the schematics. It's like a maze down here.
There's nothing on record. Bruce, are you sure about this? Sounds like a suicide mission.
I've got no choice. I've tuned the scanner to detect the spores required to make the antivenom. It'll lead me straight to them.
What about Croc?
Croc's just an animal. And animals just need traps and the right bait. I'll be fine. I'll contact you when I'm done.
It's a big old bunch of gel. Okay, so... That little... meter thing in the corner...
Will support me.
It basically tells you where you have to go.
Giving away my position.
And when the numbers start to decrease, that means you're going the right way. If they increase, then you're going the wrong way. And you'll also notice that there's a little sound barrier there. The yellow dotted lines is your barrier, and that white line that's moving up and down, that's your sound. So when your sound starts to get like faster like that, it means you gotta be quiet. So you're gonna want to crouch or just walk the whole way. You don't want to run. Unless the game tells you to, because there are some points where you have to run. Last but not least, this is probably the most important. Always have your batarang handy. You might need to switch weapons at some points during this fight, but always have it handy. The only way to hit Croc is to aim and throw the batarang. Don't quick fire. If you quick fire, it won't hit him and he'll get you. Very dissimilar in the Scarecrow boss fight in the sense that if he gets you once, you're dead. So you're gonna wanna be very careful with what you do and you're gonna wanna think quickly. Shit. I didn't mean to make noise. It was an accident. But this is the first spore. This is what it's going to look like, and we need 5 of them.
These spores don't contain enough of the antivenom mold. I'm going to need to find more.
Do you? What does it smell like? Does it smell like aftershave? Oh God! He was right behind me. I got scared for a second. Alright. I thought he was gonna grab me when I was in the middle of grabbing those spores. It scared me. Relax, Croc. When I first played this game, I was so scared of this mission, man. I got lost very easily. Oh, I'm just gonna start running. Just gonna run. You can run when he pops out of the water, because that means he's behind you, and you can just move faster if you need to. Thanks for getting that door, buddy. There's a spore here. And just so you know, Croc will come out of that door right there. So you're going to want to be careful. Because once you're done gathering the spore, you're going to have to, like, be ready instantly. Now. I can be a little quieter than that. Well, just gather the spore. What you want to do is just zip line across. And Croc will try to grab you, but he'll just miss. It's just there to scare you. See? But once you're done, always switch back to your Batarang. You don't want to have the wrong gadget. And whenever it tells you to run, just friggin' book it, the whole thing.
I will feast on your bones.
No? Uh-uh. No thanks. I ain't having that. None of them Girl Scout cookies, bud. I'm good. Okay. Here's the last spore. And that meter thing is more or less what's gonna help us get back.
I've got enough spores. I need to get back to the Batcave and formulate the antidote.
Oh, I get it. You've activated a sonar beacon down there. Clever.
Oracle, I'm getting out of here.
What about Croc?
He won't be a problem.
He's gonna pop up right now in front of you. So if you're playing the game, be careful for that. And now you just gotta zip line across here because, for me, he just screwed me over. And destroy those platforms. Oh god. Nope. Nope. No, thank you. None of that. I'm good. Shit, I went the wrong way. Okay. I just made a wrong turn, so I had to turn back. Okay, I'm supposed to go this way. Oh god! If you stand on one of those platforms when it breaks, you'll die instantly. Oh, shit. Because when it breaks, he'll be able to grab you.
I can find you, Batman!
You can. Oh, dear lord. He's right there. Oh, my god. Oh, crap. Okay, I'm going the right way. Good. I've been doing it the whole game. Uh. Now, we set up that explosive gel for a reason. And when he steps on it, you're going to want to detonate it instantly. Once again, if you don't, he'll get you. Okay, one heart attack done. Well, I think that's going to be it for this episode. In the next episode, we're going to make our way to the Batcave down there, and we're going to mix up the Titan antidote. So, thank you guys so much for watching. Like, comment, subscribe, and I'll see you guys.